Hi.
I'm back.
You're back.
We're all back.
I got a new mic stand,
which allows me to like move my hands while talking. See, I'm able to continue talking. My hands are still moving. You can hear me the same volume. So the last time you guys saw me, you saw me doing something that none of you had asked for. So we're going to continue that trend and do something again that you did not ask for. Everywhere at the end of time, you have probably heard of it. Maybe, maybe not. It's kind of a cult classic at this point. Music Twitter
sucks its dick 24/7.
Since Music Twitter loves it, I thought I should listen to it and review it so that I can tell normal people what it's like. So before I begin this review, I would like to give a trigger warning because I'm going to talk about dementia and Alzheimer's. I know that's a bit of a sensitive topic for a lot of you there, as it was for me at one point of time too. So I would suggest, if you're not comfortable with these type of topics, that you quit this video and watch my collab with Arjesh, one of my good friends. I'll link his video down in the description so that you guys can watch it. Please do support him. It's a really well-made video and it's also kind of his first video, so...
Yes, that is a plug. Fuck you.
Also, before I start, I wanted to explain to you what I think I am for this channel. I am not a music critic. I'm not another Anthony Fantano. I'm not like Pitchfork. I'm not Ego from Ratatouille. I'm just an average music enjoyer. I've never learned music theory. I don't play an instrument well. I can't sing. I can barely produce. So I'm just an average talentless piece of shit. I shit on / fanboy over music solely based on what I attempt to understand of it. I don't understand the exact way it's made. I don't know what flows into what. All you posh people, what are the fuck you say? Like, oh yeah, oh god, progress. I don't know that shit. I don't know how to make it. I don't know how to recreate it. I'm just a person who listens to it. I just consume this form of media. I don't really know anything out of consuming. So 100%, I am not an art critic. So the Caretakers Everywhere at the End of Time would basically be my biggest enemy to review, because it is a full-on art project whose nuances can only fully be understood if you know the ins and outs of music theory. It is the type of art project where rich posh people be like, oh, the impressionistic themes portray that capitalism is a deep-rooted issue in our society and you can shove it up your ass. So definitely for someone whose first review was a Lil Uzi Vert album, this was going to be hard to cover. So, how is it for a dumb brain like mine? Very good, but I can't explain why I think it is brilliant as it is. The only thing I can give you as a reason is this 6-hour album makes you feel
exaggerated
like
swagger.
No, wait, that's not it. Something's wrong with this. This 6-hour album, yes, I said 6 hours, makes you feel like you're losing your mind. Hey, look at that, I fucked up your in the script, huh? Maybe I am losing my mind. It is supposed to give you the closest experience to what it is like to have dementia. It's so long because a life with dementia would feel like an eternity. The album starts off with this like 1920s ballroom type beat thing. And it just slowly, very, very slowly degrades into ambient music. And occasionally there'll just be random silent bits in the middle. Like, as you go from stages 1 to 6, you will start to see the music starting to get a little more scary, a little more ambient and a little quieter, and everything seeming a lot less, you know. One of my friends also pointed out that there is a main theme that played out at the start, which starts to get more and more muddled up, starts to sound off key at times, and then like slowly after a certain point, it just goes away. That's kind of how dementia works. It is absolutely haunting, and it is exactly how I would imagine dementia to sound. I have had more insight into the subject of dementia than the normal person would, so this album really, really hit hard for me. As a casual listener who doesn't understand composition fully, the way these sounds make you feel is what the album does best. This album really showed me how powerful music can... Music? This album made me realize what a powerful tool music can be and how it can make you feel this very, very specific thing. Sometimes even the silent parts hit, bro. I don't even know how it's possible. When it goes silent, you're like, okay, maybe it's finally over. And then you can like finally chill out and you can like watch another couple of Nottingham Reds videos or something like that. But then you realize there's still like an hour left. Why is there just a random 10-minute section of silence in the middle? And based off like the main theme, you try to piece together your own story as to why that thing happened the way it did. You start to bring new meaning into the music yourself based on your own experiences with dementia. Us humans do not truly understand why dementia is the way it is or what caused dementia in the first place. The beauty of this album is that it's trying to spark different ideas in people about dementia and Alzheimer's so that you can discuss and collectively come to some form of, you know, like, conclusion. So 100%, this is a masterpiece. 100%. But it is one that I will never listen to again. It bums me the fuck out. I almost cried like 3 times, and I don't cry that often with music unless we're talking Future. So I give Everywhere at the End of Time by The Caretaker a 10 out of 10, and my very first Big Brain Award.
I would like to thank the Academy and I'd like to thank Nottingham Reds for giving us this prestigious award, and I'd like to announce as well that the Trench video will be coming in